Hi friends, today we are going to discuss fluid mechanics chapter number 2, hydrostatic force. I hope this session is very useful for polytechnic TRB exam, gate exam and other state government exams. So let's start the session. Here we are discuss some important points related to this chapter. So 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square or 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. 1 kilo Pascal is equal to 1000 Pascal. 1 poise is equal to 100 centipoise or 1 by 10 of Newton seconds per meter square. 1 stroke is equal to 10 to the power of -4 meter square per second. Hydrostatic force on the submerged surface. So here different cases are given. For the different cases, for force and center of pressure are listed in this table. It is very useful, friends. So next table, it is a simple table. Depth of center of pressure for some vertical plane surface from liquid surface. So here rectangle surface, CG and center of pressure. That means center of gravity and center of pressure as listed here. Similarly for different type of sections. So this is the simple table which I make for different type of section, their areas and moment of inertia. So first rectangle section, the moment of inertia about the top, that means BD cube by 3. Moment of inertia about the centroid, BD cube by 12. Moment of inertia about the base is equal to BD cube by 3. Similarly for triangle section, moment of inertia about the apex, BH cube by 4. So centroid, BH cube by 36. About the base, BH cube by 12. Similarly for circular section and rhombus, triangle, isosceles triangle and half circle, quarter circle, parabola and half parabola. For the different type of sections, their area and moment of inertia is listed here. I hope it is very useful. So let me discuss the some problems. First problem, a rectangular lamina 2 meter by 1 meter held in water at a depth of 1.5 meter below the free water surface. If the 2 meter height is vertical, determine the total pressure force and depth of center of pressure. Second problem, the another circular lamina having same area of rectangle is also kept 1.5 meter below the free water surface. Same, determine the total pressure and depth of center of pressure. So here the figure represents the rectangular lamina 2 meter by 1 meter is 1.5 meter below the free water surface. So now we are going to find out the total pressure and depth of center of pressure. So area of rectangle lamina 2 meter by 1 meter and depth of below the free water surface is 1.5 meter as given. Now the x bar is equal to the rectangle lamina 2 meter is in a vertical side. So 2 by 2 plus 1.5 meter. So now the total force you will find 49.05 kilonewton. Similarly, depth of center of pressure H bar is equal to IGG divided by AX bar plus X bar. The IGG, the moment of inertia, it will take about the centroid. So BD cube by 12. So it's come around 0.67 meter cube. Now the X bar 2.634 meter. Next problem. Similar problem, but instead of rectangle lamina, the circular lamina. So now the diameter of the circle we have to find. So area is equal to 2. So pi d squared divided by 2, it is equal to pi d squared divided by 4, it is equal to 2. From this, find diameter of the circle. So it's come 1.6 meter. Now x bar is equal to 1.6 divided by 2 plus 1.5. You will get through 2.3 meter. Now the force W into A into X bar, you will obtain 45.126 kilonewton. Then depth of center of pressure, same IgG divided by A x bar plus x bar. Here IgG, it is a circular lamina. So pi d power 4 divided by 64. You will get 0.321 meter power 4. Now x bar is equal to 2.36 meter. Problem number 2, a tank section is made half circle of 1 meter diameter. Find the total of pressure and depth of center of pressure. Here the half circle problem. So now the total pressure W into A into x bar. So x bar is equal to 2 by 3 into d divided by pi. This already we are given in table. So from this substitute and find the x bar value and total pressure F is equal to, you will get 0.817 kilonewton. And depth of center of pressure IgG divided by A into x bar plus x bar. Here IgG for this section 0.1102 r power 4. So you will get the value 6.88 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Now x bar is equal to 0.295 meter. Next problem number 3. A square lamina of 1 meter side is kept in the water being diagonal vertical, and its vertex is 1 meter below the free water surface. Find total pressure and center of pressure. Here the rectangular square lamina, but it is placed diagonal vertical. So the sides of the square is 1 meter by 1 meter. So now find x bar. The x bar is equal to the first given the name to the lamina A, B, C, D and center point E. So now we need for center AE. That means AB square is equal to AE square plus EB square. So AE equal to EB. So that's why we take an 2 AE. So AB value no 1. So AB square, that means 1 square, it is equal to 2 times the AE square. So 2 comes in this side, 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 of AE square. Now AE equal to root of 1 by 2. That's come 0.707 meter. So the lamina 1 meter below the water surface. So 0.707 plus 1, you will get x bar is equal to 1.707 meter. Now the total pressure F is equal to W into A into x bar. So it's a square lamina. So 1 meter by 1 meter, you will get the area is 1. So total pressure 16.75 kilonewton. Now depth of center of pressure, same IgG divided by A x bar plus x bar. Here square lamina, rhombus, in this shape is rhombus. So IgG is equal to A power 4 divided by 12 or D power 4 divided by 48. So IgG you will get 0.083 mm power 4. Now the h bar is equal to 1.707 plus 0.083 divided by 1 into 1.0707. So you will get 1.757 meter. Next problem number 4. Find the total pressure and center of pressure on a plate of 3 meter diameter and with a concentric hole of 1 meter diameter when its top point is 2 meter below the water surface. So here the circular section, so hole is made 1 meter, concentric hole is made 1 meter diameter. So the section is 2 meter below the water surface. Now the x bar is 3 by 2 plus 2 meter, you will get 3.5 meter. So now the total pressure W A x bar, here A is equal to pi d square by 4, that means pi by 4 into 3 square minus 2 square, you will get 3.925. Now the force is, you will get 135.6 kilonewton. Now the depth of center of pressure, here IgG pi by 64 into 3 power 4 minus 2 power 4. So you will get x bar is equal to 3.73 meter. So next problem number 5. Here the hydraulic pressure has a ram of 40 centimeter diameter and plunger of 5 centimeter diameter. If the force applied on the plunger is 200 newton, find the weight lifted by the pressure. In the figure I shown, the left side is the ram and right side is a plunger. And in right side, 5 cm diameter plunger, 200 Newton force is applied. So applied, the plunger is pressed in the ram. The weight lifted by the ram, what is kg or Newton, that has to find. So now the pressure is equal to force by area. So this right hand side is equal to left hand side. So force on weight on a ram divided by area on the ram is equal to force on a plunger divided by area on the plunger. So you will substitute the values, you will get the W. That means W is equal to force on the plunger 200 into area of the ram divided by area of the plunger. So that's pi d squared divided by 4 into pi d squared divided by 4. You will cancel all pi by 4. So only d, that means diameter of the ram 40 divided by diameter of the plunger 40 divided by 5 the whole square. So you will get the value of W equal to 128,000 Newton. So next problem number 5, a gate problem. A vertical gate is 5 meter wide. There is a water 10 meter on the one side and 4 meter to the other side. Find the resultant force, resultant horizontal force on the gate and position of its action. So resultant force is equal to left hand side force is equal to minus right hand side force. So now find the left hand side force. So F1 is equal to W into A into X bar. So now W equal to 9.81 into area of the gate is 10 meter by 5 meter. So 10 wide is 5 meter. So 10 into 5 and depth of the water stored in one side, left hand side is 10 meter. So 10 divided by 2. You will get the left hand side force is equal to 2452.5 kilonewton. Similarly, right hand side force 9.81 into 10 into 5 into 4 by 2. Here the right hand side is depth of water is 4 by 2. So 4 divided by 2. You will get the value 392.4 kilonewton. Now the resultant force F is equal to F1 minus F2. You will get 2060.1 kilonewton. Now the position of its action. The position of its action for the gate, H bar is equal to F1 into H1 by 3 minus F2 into H2 by 3 divided by resultant force F. So you substitute the values above which we are get and find the H bar is equal to 3.71 meter. I hope this session will be very useful for your upcoming exams. Thank you friends. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and share to your friends. Thank you.